So your the test that you played a role in developing, which is, I believe, used by Quest Diagnostics, it's like based on physics, so essentially,
Yes,
right? You're just throwing these particles through the air, and based on the way they're going through the air, you can figure out their density. But why is that not used in medicine? And can we get physicians to start adopting this? I mean.
Well, of course, I disclose here that along the way, because of my interest in live protein metabolism and where I've been able to do my work initially at the Lawrence Berkeley Lab and now here at Children's Hospital, I've been able to work with people that have had analytic capabilities that have led to methodologies of the most recent, and this is the one you mentioned. I'll come back in a minute to that particular method, but we brought this to the public through industry, and so we do have patents, and they've been licensed to do this methodology. So that's a disclosure, but that's the way you get things out there is through that kind of partnership, and it has penetrated a certain segment of the preventive cardiology community. There are lipidologists in particular who are proliferating. Fortunately, there's a lot of lipid education going on, and the people that are really skilled in understanding lipid metabolism are at least thinking about live protein particles, not necessarily yet about subfractions, but at least a particle versus LDL cholesterol is taking you in the right direction, because that's really the first step in terms of narrowing down the focus on what you should be treating. That's being understood, but it's still a relatively small percentage of the entire medical community that would consider themselves lipidologists or cardiologists. What about the rest of the physician community? Well, they've been confused, and part of that is because there's been a number of methods that have been out there, not just the ones that I developed, but others that have used different systems and different calibration, different ways of organizing the data, different ways of trying to educate the public, a lot of it driven by the companies that have promoted these methods. And so physicians were getting barraged and still are with competing claims for this or that method, not as well standardized, certainly, as the LDL cholesterol measurement. So it's been kind of given a back seat, in part because of that confusion, in part because a lot of people still are not convinced that, even my colleagues, even the lipidology community, is not fully convinced that the smaller particles are that much worse than the larger particles, despite all the data we have. So I'm always on the trail trying to sort of remind people of what the data show. I give a talk called "Not All LDL Particles Are Created Equal." And people just need to understand that. There's been a slow uptake because of the confusion, scientific confusion, the methodological confusion, and at one point it was a price issue as well. Is it really cost-effective to be using this test in, hundreds of thousands or millions of people when it costs an arm and a leg? Well, this new method that it's not so new anymore. I've been working on it for like over 10 years.
Right.
But Quest did partner with us and has been now more actively engaged in supporting the development of this methodology, improvement in methodologies to be more refined. So this is one of the more refined measurements. In fact, it is the most refined measurement we have for live protein analysis, using this technique called ion mobility, which sprays particles into air. And then we count them as a function of their size, and it's very elegant. It's based on physics. And it works, and it gives us data that is entirely consistent with everything we've known from our previous methods. It's standardization is in progress, but it's relatively easily standardized. And its cost has come down to something, that's not that much more than doing a standard cholesterol panel. So none of those things should be barriers anymore. So I'm hoping that as time goes on, hopefully within my lifetime, that physicians will see the role of this in their clinical practice. Certainly, when they're trying to make a treatment decision, if they're considering a patient for some sort of intervention, I think that's where the particle analysis really is important. For screening the population, I think one could argue the standard lipid tests do a fairly good job. But if you're having somebody, if you or in my case, my patients, are on the cusp about whether they should be dealing with their lipids, I think these measurements add enormously to our ability to target those people who would benefit from certain kinds of treatments, statins, diet, and then monitoring them as they're undergoing treatment.